Hello guys, so in this lecture we'll see the concept of routing algorithms. So first one we'll see what is the term routing. Okay, so let us begin with this one. Let's say one host A is there that is connected to one router R1. This is connected to, let's say, router R2. One more router is there. Then let's say B is the destination. And this router is connected to one more router R3 and so on. Let's say this is connected to R4 also. And this one is connected to, let's say, R5 also. Isn't it? Okay. Now we can say that whenever A will transmit, we can say that it's a packet, it will be forwarded to this router, that is router R1. Whenever this packet will come to the router R1, then yes, we can say that how router R1 knows that on which path this particular packet must be forwarded, isn't it? So because of that, we can say that at R1, one routing table will be there. Yes, this routing table will be there, will be having so many entries. Routing table, isn't it? Now, yes, with the help of routing table, we can say that routing algorithm will be applied, isn't it? And router R1 will get to know on which path this particular packet should be forwarded, isn't it? So with the help of this routing table, we can say that this packet will be forwarded to R2, yes, we can say that finally station B at destination, isn't it? Now, what is the meaning of actually this routing? Routing means, yes, the process of preparing this routing table is known as what? Routing. Yes, so you can write down process of preparing routing table is known as routing, isn't it? So that's all about, we can say that the term routing. Now one more thing is there, that is known as flooding. Flooding means what? We can say that, let's say this is station A. This is connected to router R1. This is connected to, let's say, router R2, isn't it? Then one more router, then finally station B, let's say that is destination. This is, let's say, R3, isn't it? Next one, let's say, this is R4, router R4, then one more router, let's say R5, then one more router, let's say R6, isn't it? Let's say, this is some network. So flooding means what? We can say that this packet, let's say one packet is forwarded by the station A, it will go to the R1. Now we can say that it will be forwarded in all other, yes, ongoing, we can say that, directions, isn't it? So one copies will be forwarded in all the directions except the direction from which it is arrived, isn't it? Okay, so we can say that, yes, we can say that now, yes, whenever it will come to any router, then it will forward it into all remaining ongoing directions except the direction from which it came, isn't it? So that is the, we can say that flooding. So we can say that with the help of flooding, everywhere various copies will be generated and will be forwarded, isn't it? So here we can say that if we see the advantages of flooding. Advantages, we can say that, yes, here first, routing is not required, because so we can say that routing will require some extra energy, some extra calculation and all. So here routing is not required. Next one, we can say that it is highly reliable. Reliable means, we can say that, yes, it will be forwarded in all the directions. So we can say that somehow it will reach the destination. If any path, we can say that any link is down, isn't it? So yes, or more than one links are down, then we can say that from another path it can reach to the destination, isn't it? So it is highly reliable, isn't it? But what are the disadvantages of flooding? Disadvantages, so we can say that first one is more traffic, isn't it? So we can say that yes, if this particular packet is generated and copies will be generated and will be forwarded in the all the directions, so we can say that there will be very high traffic in the network. Next one, yes, we can say that various packets will reach at the destination B. So we can say that yes, some various duplicate packets will reach to the destination B, isn't it? So that is the disadvantage. So we can say that yes, these are the advantages and disadvantages of flooding, isn't it? So if we talk about, we can say that routing. So what are the advantages of routing? So first one, there won't be any duplicate packet. So we can say that no duplicate packet will be there. Next one, traffic will be very less, isn't it? Traffic is very less, isn't it? Next one, if we talk about the disadvantages of routing, so first one, we can say that routing tables are required. That means some kind of database will be required, isn't it? And we can say that reliability is less as compared to flooding. Reliability is less as compared to flooding, isn't it? So these are the advantages and disadvantages, isn't it? Next one, we'll see, yes, types of routing algorithms. Types of routing algorithms. So in this topic, types of routing algorithms, we can say that routing is basically is of two types. First one is static, and second one we can say that that is dynamic. So static means what? Let's say this is the, we can say that network containing various routers, isn't it? So we can say that yes, some network is there in the world. We can say that that network must be we can say that studied first. Yes, we have to find out the shortest path and all, and we can say that we need a complete research about that particular network in the world, isn't it? Once research is done, then we can say that that can be manually done. Now, yes, we can say that now routing tables will be uploaded, we can say that offline, isn't it? Some research is done, isn't it? After that, we can say that yes, isn't it? These are uploaded offline and this can be done manually. But what happens, we can say that number of routers are not fixed. Every day some routers are going to add in the network, some routers may get down, isn't it? So we can say that yes, every time we can say that we need to we can say that sit and watch the and about the entire network, then it is possible only, isn't it? So we can say that let's say one link get down, let's say this link get down, isn't it? Now we can say that in this path, yes, the packet will not be transmitted, isn't it? So in dynamic, what will happen? In dynamic, we can say that yes, if any link get down, any router get down, and if any router is added to the network, so accordingly updations will be there, isn't it? Accordingly updations will be there. So that is known as dynamic routing, isn't it? So yes, in the dynamic routing, two types of algorithms are there. First one is distance vector routing. Distance vector routing. Dynamic means we can say that if in any path there is more traffic at this instant or at this moment, then immediately we can say that automatically, yes, the path will be changed using the routing algorithms. Isn't it? Means dynamically everything will be happening. Okay. Next one, in short, we can say that that is DVR. Second one is LSR, link state routing. Link state routing. So we can say that is LSR. So these two algorithms are in the GATE syllabus. So we are going to discuss these two algorithms. Then we can say that routing will be over, isn't it? So that will be the last part of the network layer, that is routing algorithms, isn't it? So we'll see a distance vector routing as well as link state routing in the upcoming lectures, isn't it? Okay guys, I hope this one is clear to everyone. Thank you so much.